Hello, thank you for organizing this great event. I am very much looking forward to meeting you all at the conference. My presentation topic is the crisis of place-based labor at the crossroads of planetary gentrification and the COVID-19 pandemic. I want to start with introducing you İsmail Usta. Usta means craftsman in Turkish, and we use usta to respect craftsmanship, like İsmail, Uncle İsmail. Like we use usta, the word usta, with the actual names of craftsmen. İsmail Usta is the first balishu making master of Turkey. He served for the state opera and ballet for many years, and before he became a governmental worker, he opened this workshop place. He was making shoes, and then he learned making ballet shoes, and after his retirement he continued making dance shoes, all kinds of dance shoes for the citizens in this place. His workshop is located in a district in Ankara called Hacı Bayram, and this place is under urban renewal project in the last decade. It's in the historical center of the city in Ulus, so it's very central. And during our interview, we came to a point that İsmail Usta was facing forcible displacement because his monthly rent was increased and it was not affordable for him. And then during our interview, he said that, quote, "It does not matter to me. My job is placeless. I could make shoes at home and sell it online." However, he narrated his practice as a place-based labor, and it was using not just exchange labor, but it was producing the use value of the place. So it was a placemaking practice. It was making a community around him. He was randomly meeting his customers. He was following their careers, dance careers. He was invited to their rituals like ceremonies, wedding ceremonies and burials. And therefore he established a network in this place. And another feature of place-based labor is translocal linkages. Although it's not a case in İsmail Usta's narrative, translocal linkages is very significant in the conceptualization of place-based labor, because labor and the place is never just restricted within the locale. So there are diverse urban histories, diverse actors, who are not at the center of the histories of labor and place. However, these three features of place-based labor is very significant for the cities and the districts. However, it's in a crisis at the planetary level, and the conceptualization of planetary gentrification holds a very significant place in urban studies in the recent years, and indeed particularly after 2008 global financial crisis. Planetary gentrification studies emerging mobilities and new urban actors between migrant and tourist, and it touches to some field work, some case works are touching to place-based labor too, and the others are looking at housing crisis, rent gaps, new mobilities, and the new actors, new high-income middle-class actors of these new mobilities, which has been never that much intense. So cities and districts are under the threat of planetary gentrification because place-based labor establishes the value of a place, the history of a place, like Exarchia in Greece, our close neighbor. In Exarchia, the district is known as anarchist movements, but I conducted a fieldwork in this place in 2017 and 18, and it's a very diverse neighborhood, and there are weekly protests against the police. I mean, every Friday and every Saturday there are protests against and fight against the police, and this fight itself has been commodified to represent the district as a lifestyle, as a romantic area for newcomers who are coming from mostly Europe, and place-based labor is displaced, and there are also Turkish migrants who are artisans who are cooking food and selling this food on the city to our city vendors. So they are like facing increasing rents and that kind of issues because of artists, yacht groups coming and temporarily living in Exarchia. So I will suggest to question two problematics. I will finish with two problematics for the era of post-pandemic, because pandemic stopped all human and restricted significantly the human flow. Therefore, we are in a very critical moment, I think, in the history to reframe planetary gentrification and place-based labor. And these problematics are how diverse sectors of place-based labor could be radically included in urban polities in post-pandemic era, and how could a transnational act be organized against the negative effects of planetary gentrification among labor for diverse communities. And these are the people I am referring during my presentation. I think their work is holding a very significant place in terms of planetary gentrification. Thank you for listening.